So we started with one walk in the autumn of 2010 in a park in South Orange or East Orange, New Jersey. The next year, some Buddhist groups elsewhere in the United States had heard about our walk, and so they decided that they wanted to start walks, parallel walks, with the New York walk. And so in 2011, there was a walk, this time the East Coast walk was in New York City, in Riverside Park. Another walk was near Ann Arbor, Michigan, and the third walk was in south of San Francisco, the South Bay Area. That was, hold onto your seatbelts, so fasten your seatbelts. That was a 12-mile walk, by a group of very enthusiastic walkers. I think if we tried to propagate the idea of a 12-mile walk all around the country, we would never have gotten very far. But the South Bay group had toned down the extent of their walk till now it's just a few miles, I think 3 or 4 miles. Okay, so that was 2011. There were three walks. By 2012, the idea of starting walks had spread to many other places, so I think we had about 10 walks in 2012. And each year after that, we've had about 10 walks in the United States. And a group in England has started a walk to raise funds for Buddhist Global Relief. So this is a supporting walk in England. And then two of our partner organizations, one in India, the other in Cambodia, they hold solidarity walks in order to sort of give an expression of appreciation for the work that Buddhist Global Relief is doing to support them. And so when we take this walk this morning, we should remember that we are part of what is a worldwide walk of compassion. And the walks are spread out through the duration of the autumn period. So we had the first walk took place in San Jose last week. Now this week we're having the Connecticut walk. Next week there will be four walks, that's September 30th, in different parts of the U.S. One in a new walk in Portland, Maine. Another one in Portland, Oregon, I believe that's next week. And then October, there will be four walks, and the last walk will be in November 4th. That will be in Houston, Texas. And originally, I didn't intend to go for that walk, but after the flooding from the Hurricane Harvey hit Houston, so I decided that I would go to participate in that walk as well. Okay, so this walk, the Connecticut walk, is somewhat different from all of the other walks. That all of the other walks take place either in large parks or down city or urban streets. And so in those walks, one is walking exposed to the public generally and walking at a fairly normal pace. But here we're going to be walking through the woods behind the temple. And so we walk at a very slow pace, and this is a very meditative walk. So as we walk, in the other walks, people walk in pairs or in groups and they're able to chat with each other. But here we walk in single file at a very slow pace. And so this should be a meditative walk. And so as you're walking, you can reflect on, with each step, you could be thinking of the people, hungry people around the world, the people living in very oppressive states of poverty, conditions of poverty, who are dependent upon the help from others, and that our walk is contributing in a small way to uplift the standing, the economic and food security of others. And so you can make this, as you're walking, a very literal walk of compassion, extending compassion to those in need, and also rejoicing in the role that we are playing to uplift those in need. is I'm going to let Achan Boldian lead the walk. Since he knows the route, I'm afraid if I were to lead, I would get lost.
You remember last year, you know that.
Yeah, but
I want to go you first. Yes. Yes, I must follow you.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Mama, your pressure.